Tonight, there is a guilty verdict for a Baltimore teenager accused of shooting a little girl. 11 News I-Team reporter Barry Sims has been following the Lamont Davis trial. He's been following it from the very beginning, and he joins us live from the courthouse east with more on today's verdict. Barry?
Well, this definitely was not the kind of day Lamont Davis wanted. A jury decides his case and convicts him on his 18th birthday. Stunned by the verdict, family members of a teenager who was on trial left court without making a comment. A Baltimore City jury convicted Lamont Davis on his 18th birthday. Jurors were convinced it was him on surveillance video from a police blue light camera recklessly firing a handgun. The video from July 2009 was important evidence in the case, according to Major Terrence McLarney.
To me and the squad that worked the case, the video was compelling, certainly.
The jury convicted Davis of first degree and second degree attempted murder in the shootings of a 17-year-old known as Reds, who is now in a juvenile program in Pittsburgh, and Raven Wyatt. She suffered the severest injury. She is recovering from a gunshot wound to the head.
Yes, I'm glad that it's over.
Raven's mother, Danielle Brooks, was in court for the verdict and gave an update on her daughter's health.
Yeah, she's doing fine. I mean, she's coming along good.
Prosecutors called the case complex and frustrating. According to testimony, Reds spit in the face of 16-year-old Denasia Hall that led to a street fight. Prosecutors believe Hall's boyfriend, Davis, left the 300 block of South Pulaski Street, returned with a gun, and started firing. The defense tried to show the shooter was another teen, Maurice Powell, known as Murder.
We saw witnesses going underground. We had witnesses who could not be located. We had witnesses who recanted their statements. We had witnesses who wanted to take their Fifth Amendment privilege. We had witnesses, when they recanted, they couldn't be located. So there were so many issues.
Including evidence that Davis was on a GPS home detention monitoring system, but hours before the shootings, the Department of Juvenile Services could not find him. Jurors convicted Davis, convinced he was the shooter. Davis could receive a life in prison sentence when he is sentenced on June 15th. His attorney is seeking a new trial. Reporting live from downtown Baltimore, Barry Sims, WBAL-TV, 11 News.
As a footnote to this story, our I-Team investigation last fall raised questions about the reliability of the GPS monitoring system used on Maryland juveniles. Juvenile Services authorities have extended the contract with the monitoring company through August of 2013, but they tell 11 News they have commissioned an independent review of the monitoring system.